Welcome to our video series on QuickBooks, the ultimate security. QuickBooks has great security features, but they can all be undermined if you don't properly prepare for things that you need to do before you even get to QuickBooks. Before you get to QuickBooks, you have to manage three additional things, or all the security features in QuickBooks will be undermined. You have to manage the people whom you're hiring to work with your QuickBooks. You have to manage your office, and this means physically what must be there regarding equipment and regarding the time of things that happen in your office. And of course, you have to manage your computer. Now, there are bonus videos at the end of this course with lots of detail for each of these three things. But in this beginning introductory video, we're going to touch on some of the main points just to get you ready to be able to start putting security features into QuickBooks. Before you hire people to start working on your QuickBooks, there are some easy and very affordable things that you can do to make sure that the people whom you hire behave properly and you will not have any kind of security issue with them. Now, these are all common sense things, but they're things that most people don't think about within the context of hiring a bookkeeper or an assistant who will help them with QuickBooks. First, you really should do a background check. That's very affordable and very easy to do. You have to get the permission of the person whom you're hiring. However, it is worth it to do that. It's very unlikely the person you're hiring will be insulted. And if they want to be honest with you, they can tell you if there's anything in their background that you should be concerned about. Now, of course, many people might not be comfortable asking their new employees to submit themselves to a background check. And not all of these recommendations are for everyone. My job is to tell you what will make it the most likely that you will not have a problem with the people whom you're hiring regarding security issues. And you will greatly increase your likelihood of not having a problem if you do a background check before you hire the person who will work on your QuickBooks. Credit checks are absolutely the same idea. It might not seem important for a person to have good credit before they can work on your QuickBooks. However, our goal in this video is to make it the most statistically likely that you will not have any kind of issue. And statistics show that you are much less likely to have a security problem with an employee if, in fact, this person has good credit. Job reference checks can sometimes be helpful, but you cannot completely depend on them. Sometimes past employers can be friends with a worker even if they're a problem and they give them a good reference. The opposite is also true. Sometimes a person is a reliable, trustworthy employee and might have some falling out or some issue with a boss that where the boss might actually be wrong. So it's something additional that you could do to send a signal to the person you're hiring that you're serious about security. Drug tests are the same thing. Again, a person might have a drug habit and still be a loyal and devoted employee and still be trustworthy regarding doing QuickBooks. Again, my goal is to make it as likely as possible that the person whom you're hiring won't give you a problem. And all four of these things make it much more statistically likely that you will not have a problem. Again, the bonus videos at the end of the course will give a lot more detail on affordable, easy ways that you can do these things for your newly hired employees. I'm putting them at the end of the course because I want to get to the QuickBooks part as quickly as possible. After you hire, there are specific steps that you should take. Most people don't think about bookkeeper's insurance. Bookkeeper's insurance is very affordable. You could pay as low as $300 a year to some reputable and stable insurance companies and be covered up to $300,000 for any kind of fraud or even bookkeeping mistake that your employee might accidentally do. So again, the details of which I will include in the bonus videos at the end. I'm just giving you the quickest possible summary of the things you have to do before you get to QuickBooks. Security cameras are always a deterrent, whether they work or not. If you really want to save money, get a camera and don't tell the employee that it's broken. Put the camera right behind the computer where the employee sits, so that the camera's facing the back of the employee and the front of the screen. This will give the impression to the employee that both the employee and what's on the computer are being recorded. Again, I will give you information regarding how to do this affordably with bonus videos, but again, it doesn't have to be a functional camera. They only have to believe that it's a functional camera. The most important thing you need to do after you hire is separate the responsibilities. Separating the responsibilities includes two different things, one of which I'm going to explain in a separate slide. The most important thing you can do to keep your money secure is to make sure that the bookkeeper you hire never is able to physically write checks. If the same person who's keeping records has access to the checks, they will write themselves a check and put it down as a typical business expense, and you will never know. The person who's doing QuickBooks should never go to the bank to make deposits or withdrawals. They can make a deposit into their own account and simply leave it blank in QuickBooks, and you will never know that the money got there. They can do other funny business to cover themselves and keep the money for themselves. It's not always the easiest thing to do, but again, you want to make it as safe as possible and unlikely as possible for your employee to steal from you. The person who's doing your QuickBooks should never, never, never be able to log into your bank account online. That's the same thing as handing them access to your bank account. Now, it is true that some banks give users accounts with different levels of access and different levels of permission. And if you're in a situation where the person who does your QuickBooks must be the person who logs into your bank and you feel you have no choice, you might be able to ask your bank to give this person a separate username and password with limited permissions. But again, it's better to separate it completely. Different bookkeepers should not know each other. You might have a person coming on Monday and Wednesday who does the bank reconciliation and does some other part of QuickBooks. And you might have a different bookkeeper who comes on Tuesdays and Thursdays who does the payable part and some other part of QuickBooks. You should not have them together working together, and it's best if they don't even know that the other exists. This will help prevent something called collusion, which means employees team up to steal from you and cover their own tracks. In the video that follows this one, we will talk more about separating responsibilities. But two last points. You should limit access to the office. Make sure whoever goes in there has a key and that person is authorized. Make sure nobody can simply come in and out of the office or get to your computer without your knowledge or consent. And of course, it always helps to be present physically in the office as much as possible. This tells employees that you might walk in the door at any moment, and again, it makes it much less likely that they will try to steal from you or falsify anything in QuickBooks. And again, these important details are given at the end of the course because I want the very next video you watch to be going directly to QuickBooks. The most important point in the entire course is protect the Windows clock. The bonus videos at the end of this course will physically show you how to create usernames and passwords just to get into the computer, and these videos will also show you how you can give specific users permission to change the date and time in the Windows clock. The Windows clock is the most important thing. You have to set up users and passwords for Windows. You have to make it that only the owner and or the tech person should be the administrator, because the administrator controls everything that happens, as well as what other employees and other computer users are able to do. The computer technician must be the most trusted person in the company next to the owner. This means the same scrutiny and the same background and credit and reference checks that you would do on the bookkeeper, you must do on any computer technician you hire. In fact, a computer technician who does not know QuickBooks is just as able to steal money and falsify information as the bookkeeper themselves. Now, you may well ask, why is it that all of QuickBooks security depends on the Windows clock? Well, it's very simple. When QuickBooks records an event and stamps it with the date and the time, the date and the time that QuickBooks will stamp the event is based on whatever is in the clock in Windows, or let's say the clock in the computer, at the moment that the item is recorded. If a QuickBooks user is able to change the Windows clock, then they are able to change the date and time that events are recorded, making it easier for them to falsify records and possibly steal from you. So do not let them have permission. You must make sure that before you even set up your QuickBooks, you limit the Windows permissions.